Hello everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. Introducing the Vigor2865L-5G series. There are two router models in this series, the Vigor2865L-5G on the left, which is the base model, and the Vigor2865LAX-5G on the right. Functionally, they are identical to the 2865 router series, with the main difference being the integrated 4G-5G modem. The wireless model, 2865LAX5G on the right, is Wi-Fi 6 enabled for wireless LAN devices. Some of the key features of the Vigor2865L5G series routers are that they are 5G LTE routers with a dual nano SIM slot, and they have an XDSL and a gigabit WAN port, making them multi-WAN routers. The AX wireless model is Wi-Fi 6 enabled with AX3000 performance. These are also VPN routers suitable for small to medium sized businesses, offering up to 32 VPN tunnels, and they can also be centrally managed by Vigor ACS3 to utilise the SD-WAN capability. The front panel looks similar to the other Vigor 2865 series routers, where there is one fixed ADSL or VDSL 2 port and a switchable LAN or WAN port. There are also 5 gigabit LAN ports and a USB port that can be used for a second LTE connection via an attached USB 4G modem. It can also be used for attaching a USB flash drive or a USB temperature probe. The router is fitted with an unlocked 4G-5G modem, and the combination of the 4G and 5G capability means that this router provides excellent mobile coverage in Australia and New Zealand. Listed here are the 5G bands that are supported, which will cover most areas in Australia and New Zealand. Here we have a view of the rear of the Vigor 2865LAX 5G router. One point to note is that the router has a dual SIM card slot, and it can take two nano SIM cards, which are placed on the carrier before inserting into the SIM slot. The dual SIM slot allows you to use two mobile network providers, so that in the event that one mobile network fails, the router can switch to the secondary SIM card and its cellular network connection. It's also backward compatible with 4G LTE if a 5G network is unavailable. You'll also notice that the router now has 4 LTE antennas compared to only 2 for the older 4G LTE routers. The SIM card slot is on the right. We first need to remove the cover on the router's rear to install the SIM card. Now remove the SIM card holder by first pushing the SIM card holder in, and it will pop out. Now notice that it has two sides, so we can install two nano SIM cards. Let's install a Telstra card into the SIM 1 side and an Optus one into the SIM 2 side. If you're only installing one SIM card, install it into the SIM 1 side, which will end up on top. Now carefully insert the carrier back into the SIM slot in the router and refit the SIM card cover. The next step is to install the antennas. Note that while the connectors on the antennas would allow them to be directly attached to the router, the antenna sockets are too close together, so you'll need to install them with the 1 meter leads or they won't all fit. But that also allows the antennas to be positioned higher where they can get better signal. Note the wireless LAN antennas on the 2865LAX 5G model, which are white, do connect directly to the router. There are 4 LTE antennas in the box, and you'll need to fit them on each of the magnetic bases. Now screw each of the leads into each socket on the router. These will be the 4 inner sockets. The 2 outside sockets on the wireless router are for the Wi-Fi antennas. For the best signal, you'll usually want to get the antennas up as high as possible, and remember they are magnetic, so they'll stick to a comms cabinet or rack or anything else metal. There is a rack mount bracket available for these as well if you do want to install these routers into a rack. If you have limited space and want to tidy up the spaghetti afterwards, you can wind up the excess cables and use the twist ties to make it neater once you have the antennas in the best position. For an outdoor antenna installation, you must have at least two antennas connected. The sockets to use are the left socket on each pair nearest to the power switch. That's the left one on the first pair and the left one on the second pair. Once connected, it should look like this. Okay, once you've installed the SIM cards and attached the antennas, you're ready to start configuring the 5G connection. After logging into the router, go to the WAN General Setup menu and check that the 5G NR WAN is enabled. Next, go to the WAN Internet Access menu and select 3G, 4G, 5G modem DHCP mode. Then click on the Details tab. On the next menu that comes up, select Enable. Since we've installed two SIM cards, Telstra and Optus, we'll configure SIM 1 and SIM 2. For SIM 1, make sure it's enabled, then disable Auto APN. Depending on your internet plan, you may need to use a different APN, but I'll use the most common APNs here in this demo. Incidentally, APN stands for Access Point Name. For the Telstra SIM card, we'll use Telstra.internet as the APN. We can keep the rest of the details at default values. For SIM 2, enter Connect for the APN since this will be connecting to the Optus network. You'll notice on this menu page we have the preferred LTE band, where you can select a preferred band if you're in a location where you get better connectivity with a particular band. The network scan lets you search for available networks. The other option here is to query neighbour cells. Since we have both SIM 1 and SIM 2 enabled, you should note that SIM 1 will be the primary SIM and SIM 2 will be the backup when the SIM 1 connection goes down. Finally, click on OK to save the configuration. Now wait a couple of minutes for the 5G connection to come up. You can check the status of the connection by looking at the 5G NR status menu down here. Once the connection is up, you can see the connection details. It'll show the WAN IP address as well as the signal strength. You should now be able to connect to the internet over 5G. The integrated 5G LTE modem is a Category 19 device and with carrier aggregation can achieve high-speed mobile broadband connectivity for internet access and VPN. In wireless communication, carrier aggregation is a technique used to increase the data rate per user, whereby multiple frequency blocks are assigned to the same user. As the maximum possible data rate per user is increased, the more frequency blocks are assigned to a user. The theoretical LTE maximum download speed of a Category 19 LTE modem is 1.6 gigabits per second. The table shown here shows expected real-world speeds under ideal conditions, however actual speeds will vary due to network congestion and signal strength. Here's a quick demonstration of the 5G speed we get at our location in Sydney. The signal strength isn't great there, so we don't expect to get very high speeds. Also, network congestion will affect the speed, and this can vary throughout the day. So, we go to a speed testing website, in this case speedtest.net. Then just click on Go and wait for it to do its thing. And it says we're getting over 125 megabits per second for download, which is just a tad below that theoretical maximum of 1.6 gigabits per second. That's more in that low band area, which is pretty much what we were expecting here. And for upload speed, we're getting an average of over 11 megabits per second. I'll leave a link to this website in the description below. Let me know in the comments what sort of speed you get with your 5G connections and what city you're in. Here's a comparison of the base model 5G router and the wireless version. Essentially, they're the same, except the 2865LAX 5G includes Wi-Fi 6, so the router will have two additional dual band wireless antennas. Its maximum wireless link rate is 574 megabits per second for the 2.4 gigahertz band and 2,402 megabits per second for the 5 gigahertz band. Here we have a comparison between the older and latest model routers. The main point to note here is that the LTE technology has improved with each later model. The earlier model router, the 2862 series, was 4G Category 4 with a maximum link rate of 150 megabits per second download and 50 megabits per second upload. This improved with the 2865 LTE, which had Category 6 4G technology with improved performance. Its maximum link rate is 300 megabits per second download and 50 megabits per second upload. Now, the 5G router has Category 19 4G 5G technology with greatly improved performance. Its maximum link rate is 1600 megabits per second download and 200 megabits per second upload. In real-world scenarios, due to various factors such as signal strength and network congestion, you may not see these speeds, but you will see much greater speeds when compared to the 4G routers. Finally, here we have a comparison of some of the other features between the older and newer router models. Essentially, the feature set is very similar, with the main difference being the Wi-Fi speeds, which are higher in the later model routers. Click pause or hit the spacebar if you'd like a longer look. Thank you for watching. Please like or leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02 9838 8899.